Hi, Moussa, you okay?
Hi, I'm fine, you?
Yeah. Just wanted to ask about, obviously, last week was disappointing, the result, the performance. And Jose just said this double header against Ludogorets away and then at home is now really important in terms of qualification. Can you just give us an idea on how disappointed you were, the team were with last week, and how important you see these two matches against the Bulgarian side?
Yeah, we're all disappointed about the result of when we play in Belgium, because at the beginning of the competition, we said we would like to win a lot of games as soon as possible, try to qualify quick. And of course, we start well the first game at home. And last week, we were disappointed because we didn't play well. And I think we didn't show a good attitude on the pitch. And that's why we were all disappointed. And this was not acceptable. And I think tomorrow is a good opportunity to show, like we learned from that game. It's going to be a tough opponent. They won the last league. And yeah, it's a good team with some good player. So we have to go there with a good character and with a positive mind, and hopefully win this game and come back with a 3 points, because we cannot come back with a defeat tomorrow. Otherwise, it's gonna be difficult for the rest of the competition. But we have to make sure to go there and try to come back with a 3 points.
Just one more from me. With the schedule being so congested this year, you're playing almost, you know, two or three times a week. How difficult is it mixing the ambitions of the Europa League with the Premier League? Because Spurs have made a terrific start, and many are saying you're rightly title challengers this year.
Yeah, there is a lot of games since we start. We know that. But one thing is good is we have a good and strong squad. So everyone can play, and everyone has the opportunity to play since the beginning of the season. And our main focus is to take game after game. It's not we have to win this one because it's more important than the next one. We are all competitive and we want to go far as possible. And that's how the big team win trophy, is to take a game after game and try to win game. So now we are focused on the game on tomorrow, and we have to make sure to win that one. And after, we have the time to think about Sunday. And yeah, and step by step, we will see where we are in the later in the during the season. And but what we want is to go far as possible. And if we can win something, it will be great. But there is no one game is more important than another one. So every game is important, and everyone in the squad will be part of the game, and we all need to be ready to play.
Paul Jiggins, go to you next, please.
Hi, Moussa.
Hi.
Hello. Nobody knows Tanguy Ndombele better than you. He obviously calls you his brother. He's now showing the form that you said he would show. But can I ask you, when things were bad for him, what did you say or have to say and do to keep his spirits up, to keep him positive when he was going through the tough times?
Yeah, I think everyone are very happy with what Tanguy is doing at the moment. Of course, last year has been a tough season for him. And I can say that's normal, because I think when you're a young player and you change the country, you go somewhere where you're living alone, you don't speak the language, and the training session is totally different, and even the league, the way you play. And sometimes people need time to adapt. So it's been my case when I first came, even at Tottenham. And but I was trying to say to him just to stay calm, to be patient, and just to work at the training and try to understand everyone here. And maybe this year will not be great for you, but everyone knows you have talent, and you show it in the past. And if you came here, it's because everyone are sure you will perform. And of course, he had a few problems, but at the end, everything went fine. And we can see this year, he's very happy to be part of this team, and he's showing a lot of quality on the pitch. And all the players are happy to have Tanguy in that form. And I think he will even improve during the season. So, but what he was doing and showing, I think is good at the moment.
Thank you.
Alistair Gold, go to you next, please.
Hi there, Moussa.
Hello.
Hello there. I want to ask you about another midfielder as well you've been playing with, Pierre-Emile Højbjerg. You've seemed to have struck up a really good relationship with him on the pitch as well. Can you just tell us a little bit about how it works between the two of you on the pitch and also what he's like off the pitch as well?
So we are very pleased to have Pierre in this team. I think since he came, since the first game, he showed all his quality and he bring a lot of energy to the team, and he's a great midfield player. He had, of course, he's young, but he had also some experience because he's been playing in few teams before. And to play with him, of course, is nice. And like every player who play with him, even when Wings played a few games with him, he was very happy to play with him. And that's good. Hopefully, he's gonna keep going on that way and bring all his energy and his ability on the pitch. And even with the ball, he's a good footballer. So, yeah, I think he's a good add for the squad, and he showed it since he came. So I hope he will keep going on that way.
Thanks, Moussa.
Yeah. So I've just got one hand left, so we'll finish on Dan Kilpatrick.
Hey Moussa, does Tanguy seem like a different person off the pitch now that he's playing well on it?
No, not a different person off the pitch, but he's just maybe more open with everyone, because last year it was complicated for him here, and then when you think he's tough and you don't speak the language, so it's difficult to be open with everyone and speak with everyone. But this year is totally different. And then maybe because he's been playing and playing well, and his English is improving a lot, so he can even speak English with player in the changing room. And he's laughing, he's joking with everyone. So that's good. And that's what we wanted to see. But again, like I said, when you come and maybe you need time to adapt, and Tanguy needed that time. So, but now the past is gone. So we are all focused on now, and he's doing well. He's happy, and he's playing well. Everyone in the building is happy with what he's doing. So, let's going on that direction.